I started my journey in 86, almost 37 years back, when Citibank was just starting a consumer banking business. A lot of things were not known. Auto loans were not known that time. The new brands were not known that time. ATMs for the first time in December 87 we launched. As early as December 97 we launched the first ATM. Along with Sanjeev and Ashok Dutt, we launched first credit card on 1st of July 1990. Since then, the India landscape of technology, with the private sector bank coming in, public sector bank started to catch up on the technologies the way in 86 where the systems were, manual systems were there or a branch systems were there to getting into the core banking systems. I think the world looks very different today. And the change which is happening in different phases of the life is substantially different technologies are available. So the technologies which are available in 86 and technology which are available today in 2023 are vastly different. We talk it bank tech wave one, where the mainframes were there, to the cloud is a bank tech wave five. So there's a fifth wave of technology which we are experiencing and which we are getting benefited of it. Our competition in Europe or in US, I was talking to one CIO of the ING bank, and still in Germany they are using Unisys mainframe. I was wondering, Unisys mainframe, not even IBM mainframe, Unisys mainframe, that company doesn't exist anymore, but that mainframe exists. And the technology on that, when I was talking to him about saying, when are you planning to change? They say, no, we are not going to change. We are signing a next 10-year contract with them to run it. Now that's the kind of a fear they have on core banking, that they don't want to change anything in the core banking. So bank is such a risk-averse community that they know what is written on the wall, that Unisys mainframe to run for next 10 years. I got shock of my life that how can somebody take a decision in 2023 to work on Unisys mainframe. And over here in India, we are able to understand the technology changes. So congratulations to all of you. The way we are seeing the technology adoption in last 10 years in India is substantially fast. It was, the wave is accelerating. Between 90s to 2000, very slow. 2000 to 2010, adoption of the core banking started happening. Finacle, FlexCube started coming into picture for core banking. It's accelerated the journey. 2010 to 2020, another decade, it was accelerating, but still technology investment in Indian banking system was limited compared to the global counterparts. The kind of a scale, performance, it was okay, but now it's, as of now also the technology investments, which is a typical bank in America invest versus Indian bank invest, is very, very low. If I look at it from Citibank, they invest close to $3 billion per year for the technology. $3 billion means 24,000 crore only for technology. I don't think anybody bank spend 24,000 crore. Even 1,000 crore in technology spend looks to be high. And if you say it's a 5,000 crore, it itself will look very, very large. But they are running as good, as big a business as Citibank is running. For similar amount of business which Citibank is running, for which they are spending 24,000 crore for technology spend, Indian IT industry is surviving on that. So in the inefficiencies of the technology industry, of the global technology industry, is making our IT industry very healthy. And one of the points I picked up on Sanjeev's presentation, fragmentation. Fragmentation of the technologies, of the processes, of the product is making their cost so high. There are more than 50,000 people work for JP Morgan Chase in India alone. 50,000 technology people, 50,000 people is not a banking population in many of the banks where only technology people, outsourced by technology people are in the terms of 30,000, 40,000. They talk in thousands, they don't talk in hundreds. We talk in 20s, and we talk in 40s, and we talk in hundreds, but we don't talk in 2,000s. So I'm not saying that that is a inefficiency we want to get into with a new set of technology which is available. When we are organizing sessions for design thinking, when I started looking at 2008, 2009, that how the technology is changing, and we always use a second phrase which Sanjeev has used. We are a technology company with banking as a service. What transformation has happened as technology as a bank, we are a technology company, banking as a service versus bank as a technology as an enabling function. It's a big paradigm shift. And for that paradigm shift, we need a core value. We find when the paradigm shift happens, the business of US has moved from New York to Silicon Valley in last 20 years. The center of the gravity of the US economy was New York, Chicago, Washington. In 20 years, that center of gravity has shifted to Palo Alto, San Francisco, Seattle. That's where the entire east to west movement has happened for such a heavy economy. And when I was looking what made the difference, it is the design thinking. The West Coast has started design thinking program sometime in 1992. Stanford started a design thinking program in 1992, which was about, design thinking is about looking at the opportunity, while management is about optimizing the resources. So there's a significant difference between MBA and design thinking, where MBA teaches us how do I optimize the resources available to me. Efficiency of operational process, efficiency of customer expectation, all are efficiency driven. What Sanjeev's presentation is looking at opportunity set. And that's where the design thinking plays a critical role in the way we think design thinking, and that's where the West Coast become different from the East Coast. And it's a part of overall way one thinks. So when we are saying design thinking for digital enterprise, I'll start with anybody wants to define what is the design thinking means to you before we jump on to the answering design thinking, since you are attending this session. And you would like to share what is your view of design thinking? You want to say it?
Yeah. So it's like designing the thinking for the structure of the product you want to have.
Yeah.
How to design it efficiently, technology enabled, and how to optimize.
Beautiful. Anybody would like to add to him? Yeah.
I think it's about how we have, kind of encountering a problem.
Yeah.
From the customer's perspective, creating personas, that putting it's an empathic driven approach. When you put yourself in the customer's shoes,
that's right.
Don't try to think about the solution, define the problem, and organically figure out what the solution could be.
Beautiful.
That is what it is.
Anybody else?
Yeah, so it's more of a
Yeah.
So it's very creative. I mean, there is so much competition and so much problem statements are there. We have to come up with a creative solution, and that creativity will come with the thought process, which is like
design.
Yeah. There will be various answers on design thinking. The one answer is a creative. Second is customer. Third is around the solutions which are being driven. So there could be various ways of looking at the design thinking. And I'll start the design thinking. During the day, we'll be going through the way design thinking is understood, designing the thinking for designing the solution. So the way we look at it, the differentiation in design thinking is how the thinking process of designers who think about the solution. So there's a two part of design thinking, designing the thinking and thinking the design. So when I'm saying designing the thinking means the people who are designing the solution how do they think about the solution? How do they think about the customer? How do you think about the creativity? It's designing the thinking. It's their thinking process. So the people who are designers, who are execution, is the designing the thinking. And once they have a right set of people who can think differently, then you have a process of design which is thinking the design. So there are two sections of it. A lot of time we focus on thinking the design. At Intellect, what my discovery over the 2010 onwards is, focus, unless we have right soil on which we can have a right seed to plant. If soil is not creative, how the seeds will be creative? Process cannot make the, thus the process of design thinking cannot change the thinking process, and that's what East Coast is struggling, though they know the process of design thinking, but they're not able to apply design thinking in their culture of New York and Boston and Chicago. They're still struggling to follow design thinking in spite of they know what the design thinking means. But we need to start with a definition which is most popular in a design thinking world, which we say, what is the design thinking? It's about customer desirability. The core value is, who is the customer? What does he want? What is the desirability? Technology makes it feasible. So technology means techniques, processes, systems, all our technology. Technology doesn't mean what we deliver to the bank. Technology means all the elements which comes, techniques and tools is a technology. So the operation shop of the bank is also come under part of the technology. And then business makes it viable. The business, superior business model which makes it viable. Now, this slide looks very simple. It is there. You must have seen this slide hundreds of times, because whenever design thinking is being talked about, desirability, feasibility, viability is being talked about. Now, when I was getting into this slide, I find, do we understand desirability of the customer? We say it a lot of presentation of McKinsey, BCG, Bain, saying, oh, we should understand customer. But how do we understand the customer better? India is a state of 29 countries. It's a European Union of the world. We don't classify India. It's a European Union. Each state is so different in their characteristics, behavior, buying behavior, selling behavior. It's like a European Union. If France and Germany, the way the banking is different in France, Germany, Netherlands, Spain, and Italy, same way we have a banking is different from Tamil Nadu to West Bengal to Gujarat. Banking is substantially different. So what is the mystery of desirability? So then we need to look at second way of solving each area. How do you move from mystery to heuristics and to algorithm? So to understand the customer better, I need to move from, it's a mystery to me. Mystery of Tamil Nadu customer, how does it behave? What is the mystery around it? And then I move to some patterns I will see in Tamil Nadu, that in Coimbatore it works differently, Madurai it works differently. There are the pockets of industrial townships. And based on that, we create some heuristics. And from heuristics, I create some algorithm of banking products to be built on. And for doing that, I need to look at it. What is the stated needs and what is the unstated needs, which customer is not talking about, but we are feeling and perceiving unstated needs. We are observing pattern and anti-pattern. What works in a particular community, what doesn't work in a particular community. Then you connect the dots within the box and outside the box. And then acknowledge the spaces that I don't know what I don't know. There are spaces which are in a zone of don't know space. I don't know what I don't know. So if I don't know what I don't know, like for this conference when you are coming, a lot of things are there which may not be knowing that they exist in India, or we can share the story of our customers with you. So if we are fortunate as an organization in the last 37 years that we are working in the best banks for the Vietnam, Thailand, or in Asia, or Middle East, the best bank in Middle East, best bank in Africa, best bank in Europe, best bank in Americas, best bank in South America. So we have a exposure of understanding their needs much from differently. So everybody wants to innovate. Every country wants to innovate. When Chile wants to innovate in South America, they have a different kind of a thinking process versus France thinking process versus Italy, Italian thinking process. But we are the common source where we aggregate that data. So we can bring you some of the spaces where don't know solution which you have provided can be delivered to you. There are three laws of design thinking, which is I call law of design thinking. Less is more. Less number of products are better than a more number of products. What Sanjeev was mentioning, you need to curate the product to be less is more. Apple has a 5 products equivalent to Indian economy market cap. One company of 50,000 people is equivalent to 1.4 billion people, what we produce as enterprise value is just with the 5 products. Or 7 products. Just 7, you classify just 7 products. So less is more. Second is, last 2% is 200%. 98% of product in the market are commoditized. They are all look similar. It's the 2% which makes a difference to the your differentiation. Differentiated product, what Sanjeev was mentioning, is last 2%. And that 2% is where the huge amount of efforts goes in. When at Intellect, we have a research team of 1,200 researchers are there in our organization, one of the largest research, technology research organization in the country. And these researchers reaches to 97% very quickly. Within 6 months, they can reach to a product which is as perfect. In 6 months, one year, 2 years, they reach it. Between 97% journey to 99.5% journey, it's a huge, huge work on R&D. And that is the 2% which makes our product superior than any fintech organizations, which are may do the quickly 95% quickly right. It looks very nice on the table. But when you are doing in high performance, high volume, high complex environment of banking, their investment capacity to invest continuously, it's not that they don't have potential, but the investment capacity which is coming from the financial investor organization doesn't support them for that kind of intensity which Intellect has done over the period of time, because we are keeping this 1,200 people researcher team from last 8 years. After we separate from Polaris, this team of researchers are there continuously. Whether we make profit, whether we make losses, we invested close to 2,500 crore in R&D in last 8 years of our journey. Then when we look at the choices we make in the businesses, measure it on a weight base, weight scale, 10 gram, 100 gram, 1,000 gram. Don't say ABC. ABC doesn't give, because it's a numerical picture. When you say 10 gram, 100 gram, 1,000 gram, your feelings are important. So design thinking, feelings are as important as logic is. So rational mind and feeling mind both has to come together, and that's why the new scale is required, 10 gram, 100 gram, 1,000 gram, which is a feeling scale and an exponential scale.